Hello guys, today we are going to see how to use Nmap. So basically Nmap is a open source tool for network discovery and security auditing. It's a command line interface. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So for the demonstration of this Nmap tool, I'm using the operating system is called Linux and Metasploitable 2 as my target machine. So here you can see Metasploitable IP is 192.168.204.131. So this is our target machine. So we are going to do Nmap scan on this target IP. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So if you want to scan the single IP means you can directly type nmap, directly you can enter the IP. So like this you can able to scan this one IP address. So if you want to scan multiple IP address means you can use this command. Space you can directly enter whatever the IP you want to scan. So I will just scan 130. So here you can see the results for 192.168.204.131. So these are the results for that 131 IP, and 130 is I don't know what is this IP, and it is showing that all the 1000 scanned ports on this IP address are closed. So there are no results for this IP address because there is no active connections to this IP address. And if you want to scan the IP addresses from different ranges, so from 1 to 10 or 1 to 100 or 1 to 254 or 100 to 254, like this also you can able to scan the IPs here. So I will just scan this IPs range. I'm going to use 192.168. 204.12, just Q space 254, just enter. My IP is 131, and for the 131 this should give the result, but I entered the IP wrong here. I just gave 201, so that is not correct. I'm just going to enter 204. So here you can see the results for the range scanning. So I given the range between 1 to 254, and it is showing that here 204.1 and 204.2 and 204.131. So this is our Metasploitable machine, and you can see all the ports here and the results for that IP scanning, and here also you can see the results for this 254 and 130 also. So and by this nmap you can also able to scan your domain also. So I just want to scan this domain nmap scan me dot nmap dot org. So directly you can, if you want to scan any domain, means directly you can give nmap and the domain. So if you want to scan the Google or any Facebook domains, means directly you can give nmap facebook.com or nmap google.com or nmap yahoo.com, like that you can able to give, and you can find the results for that scanning also through this nmap. Sorry guys, it is taking too much of time, so I'll skip this one. So let's skip this one. And if you want to scan using this CIDR notation, you can scan the IP like that also. So I'll just use this CIDR notation here. So just enter nmap, enter IP 204.0/24. So here you can use 1624 or 8, you can use it. So here you can see the values for this particular IPS 131, 204.2 and 204.1. So there are basically no IPs are active in this particular IP range. So we can't able to get more results from this search. So only we can get 204.131 because we are having Metasploit permission on that particular IP. So let's imagine if you are having the different IPs. So we are having 204.131. So if you are having like 204.130 or 203.131 and 200.132. Like that. So if you are having different IPs also, you can create one particular file in the form of TXT, and you can able to scan that particular file using this nmap. So let's do that. So I will just create one text file here. So let's create SIMAPC here. 4.131. So I will just add my Windows IP also. So I just created these four IPs here, and we can create a file. So save as .txt. So I'm just saving this file in this downloads. Just save. Let's close this. So we are having where is the txt? So here we are having the target.txt. Just
nmap minus IL
So if you are importing from the file, you need to add IL here. So here you can see the results for this 204.131 IP, and these are the ports which are open in this particular IP. So here you can see the results for this all IP addresses. So here you can see for my Windows machine 205, sorry, 25.205, and host is up, and these are the ports which are open in that particular IP address. Here also you can see some of the results for this IP address 131 and 130. So in the range, if you want to exclude one IP, means you can use this command. So just you can use this nmap just exclude and just give the IP addresses. So which IP address you don't want to scan, so just give this IP addresses. And so actually only 204.131 is present in this IP's range. So if you are excluding that, means zero host will be present in that network. So there are no IP addresses will be present in that particular range to scan for those IP addresses. So next, discuss some of the scanning techniques. So till now we have seen only the IP address scanning. So by this nmap, you can do TCP and UDP port scanning. So on this 131 IP total, you can see only TCP ports are open, so no UDP ports are available. So let's search for TCP SYN ports scanning. So for that SYN port scanning, we need to enter nmap, just small s and capital S, and just give the IP address. This given the results for this SYN port scanning. And if you want to scan for the ACK port scanning, just you can enter nmap, just in the place of S you can just replace with capital A. This gives the results for that ACK port scanning. So here you can see the results for this ACK port scanning. So here it is saying that all 1000 scan ports on this are unfiltered. So now let's discuss about some port scanning. So here you can see that there is a 21 port service FTP is running, and 22 some SSH, and 23 there is a telnet service is running. So if you want to scan for the particular ports, so I just want to scan only this port, whatever is the port. So if you want to scan this port 80, so how we can do the port scanning on this particular IP address? So just nmap -p Just enter the IP address. Here you have to mention the port, just 80. So here you can see the results for this port scan. So on this port 80, so TCP open and HTTP services is running and the state is open and this port is 80. So if you want to scan some particular range from just like from 1 to 100 or 1 to 1000 like that port scanning also you can able to do. So let's try that one. So I will just enter some 2200. So it will scan what are the ports which are present between 2200. So here you can see 21, 22, 23, 25, 53 and 80 ports are available between that 21 and 20 and 100. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 ports are there between 20 and 100. Like this you can do between the different ranges. So I mean you can able to do 20 to 10,000 ports like that also you can able to scan those ports. And if you want to scan all the ports which are present over this IP address means directly you can give, sorry, just remove this one directly like this. So this command will run all the ports present in that particular IP address. So here you can see all the ports which are running on this IP address from 21 to 58,192. Actually the what are the services running on that port is currently unknown, but it is given the results for the up to just like 58,192. So by this way you can able to scan all the ports which are present over this particular IP address, I mean in the particular mission. So let's discuss about what are the services running and what are the version of that particular service. So if you want to scan for the version and what are the service running on that particular port, so directly you can run this command, just nmap minus p 21 and for the version. So here you can see the results for that the version and service running on the port. So here you can see the port is 21 and the service is FTP and that version is currently the version is 2.3.4 version is using. So by this way you can able to discover what are the services and version is running on that particular ports. Now let's discuss about this OS discussion. So if you are attacking on the machine and if you want to know the what is the operating system they are using the in that particular machine, So by this nmap, you can able to find that what is the operating system they are using in that target mission. So if you want to find that operating system, so you can use this command, and this is the capital O, and just enter this IP address, and it will give the operating system name of that target machine. So here you can see the details of this operating system. It is currently running Linux 2.6 version. So by this way you can able to find the what is the operating system they are using in that target machine. So let's try some of the scripts.
Sorry. So just enter nmap.
So just I'm using the default scripts which are present in that nmap. So just enter default. Just enter the IP address. It will take some time for running these scripts. So these are the results after running this script. But there are more scripts in this nmap. You can use that scripts for scanning these ports. So there are more different types of scripts are available, like HTTP scripts, banner script, and SMB scripts. So there are different types of scripts are available in this nmap. You can use that scripts for the scanning this ports. So and finally, if you want to print the output in a particular file, like XML file or text file, directly you can use this command. Right on. So here you can see the scanning results of that particular IP here. So what are the ports are open and services which are running in that particular IP address, you can see here. So like this way you can print the output of that particular scan using this command. So if you want to print the output in the XML format, directly you can use just XML, and in the place of N you have to replace with X. So this is XML results for that particular scan. So by this way you can able to create the outputs in the format of TXT, XML, and grep formats also. So till now we have seen particular
target scanning and scanning techniques like finding TCP SYN ports and TCP ACK ports and UDP port scan, and we have also seen the host discovery excluding a port scan in a single scan, and we have also seen port scanning, I mean particular port scanning and different port scanning in a single scan, and we have also seen services and version detection and also OS detection. We have also used some of the scripts in this scanning, and we have also created some of the output files using this nmap command line tool, and so if you don't want to use that nmap means directly you can go to this nmap graphical user interface, and this is Zenmap which is also available in the Windows, and directly you can enter the IP address here, and directly you can scan this. So I don't want to scan this, so I'm just closing this, but you can also use this Zenmap. So that's it for the video, guys. If you have learned something by watching this video, just give a like and subscribe to my channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching this video, and have a good day, guys.